Yeah. Okay, deliver it here, 2.3 kilos. Okay, good. I can open?
Yes, please open.
Okay.
Now.
It's like a bird of a baby.
Yeah.
Oh. Ooh, wow. Yeah. Look at that. It's transparent. It has some weight and it has volume. Wow. Huh. And we have to go and test it. Okay.
This nice piece now?
We look in the microscope later, you know, but I feel it. I feel the importance of the piece. It's very heavy, it has beautiful volume and everything. If this is what it's supposed to be, it will become the world record ruby.
Yes.
So now, what we're doing now, so let me organize the workflow. So I have to follow it personally. Let's walk to the lab. Hello.
Morning.
Good morning, everybody. 101.76.
Yes.
Oh, 25.08. Okay, we measure here. 8x. Jesus Christ, look at that color. Oh my mia, Jesus Christ. Chromium, iron, gallium. It's quite high iron, huh? But
iron is high, no? I'm surprised.
No, this depends on the activation energy we use. It's not, it doesn't say it has high iron.
Yeah.
It comes after the calculation, you know, because you can low energy, medium energy, high, you know,
yes.
Depending on the heavier element get more higher in peak, and you go to medium energy, then the higher iron comes down and so on. But because it's an open color, it might be still fluorescent.
Yes. Oh,
yeah.
It's very fluorescent.
All right. Okay. So that's what I think. Have to try a little bit. We will make upstairs one more time. High tech, two other infrared microscope, and the other one machine. This one is just the first one. Okay, I see this structure. It's good, nah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we can put like this and put all the documents inside. Okay. Probably getting the biggest ruby in the world.
It is. No?
World record.
I have no idea. I mean, I don't know any.
No, it has to be judged after cutting, to be fair.
Yeah.
So you can make a vibrant, perfect stone out of it. And
yes.
Then that will be the world record.
Yes.
History world record ruby ever found on the planet Earth. Because
I have
40 years I looking at all the best stones in the world. The final is always after cutting.
Yeah,
you know?
I agree.
So we have to be careful. But the potential is there.
Yeah.
That's why all this special effort sending it here and all this and that.
Exactly.
So this is a stone that walks with the directors at the upper floor and handed from director to director and doesn't go another level. Be careful with stone, huh? No dropping. It's too big?
Yeah.
Okay, not put in. No make.
Yeah.
No make. Take out. Put to the other machine. Moment. Okay. All right. Fluorescent. Baseline?
Can I have a look?
Yeah. No dropping, nothing. It's 20 millions, just copper load.
Then we need a color stability test run.
That's something, huh?
That's a big boy, huh?
Mm. We haven't seen that before yet, huh?
Me for sure. And you?
One. But a little bit smaller, but depends what coming out after cut.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
So let me have a look.
Yes.
That is what the reaction we want. Wow.
And it's on in.
Look at that.
Yeah, right.
That's
it's glowing, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, strong.
Yeah.
The look.
Strong. Medium strong.
No, because the rim, the rim of it, you know, shows more fluorescence than the center. So
yeah.
You have to judge the final stone. But I would say it goes into strong.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Turn it off. You see, there are some internal cracks, a little bit something, as you know. A little bit is there.
Small fissures, maybe.
That has to be seen after cutting.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not like without, but it is. It doesn't have big cracks.
Mm-hmm.
The silk is very small. It's very fine.
Yes.
So it's not going to be reflective platelets. There
yes.
are no platelets. Only silk. The silk normally you can manage
yes.
with the light going through.
Yes.
It is under the table. Is a little bit silk. You know, in the center.
Yes.
But when you make a vibrant cut with a big depth, you can overpower this area,
yes.
you know. The crack on the crown is not going in much on this side. There is one, is it a feather? Moment, please, this one. This one is to be supposed to be the table, huh?
Yes.
So you have one little issue. The table has that big line going through. It's a fluid inclusion feather.
Okay.
No, I mean, after you polish that, you will see quickly whether it's a crack or not.
Yeah.
Right. But I think it's not. No, it's not a crack. It's a fluid inclusion feather. That means half of the crack is healed.
Mm.
It's a healed one. It will not break.
Mm.
Yeah. And then you have all this volume. So I guess you will get a 53.5 carat stone out of it.
Excellent out of it.
That's what you calculated?
Yes. Anywhere between 52 to 56.
So now we register the inclusions. Here is this very fine silk in the stone. Very fine silk. I take it a little bit up more. Here's the feature that goes through the table.
Could that be because of that breakage at the back?
What?
That line in the table?
No, it's not a reflection. It's truly a fluid feather. With little dots of the fluids, you know. You want to put the optical axis
yeah,
on the table, huh?
That is the optic axis, the axis.
So perpendicular to it should be the orange color, which we definitively very
yeah,
clearly
that is
see.
The AB one.
Yeah.
That
you
is
want to go through
orange,
this?
Right, doctor?
Go to it. Photos are done. Dimensions done. Retake dimension. Second dimension meter.
Calculate 10% for the bulge.
Make the depths different because the depths, I mean, 15, which is only slight because you want to make it vibrant.
Slight, yes.
The word thickness you can increase, we can make it slightly thick, 2%. We can change to cushion, okay, instead of.